It was a bright and sunny day for the most part, with that eclipse being the exception. All day today in Vegas, and it's also a time for new beginnings. Literally, a new name to this Vegas family forum, and it's been the longest layoff of the season for the Vegas Thrill, looking to get things turned around, facing off against first place Atlanta here in Henderson. Glad to have you with us, AJ Cannell, alongside Kirsten Olsen, filling in for Vic today. And Vegas looking to get back on track, but a very, very difficult test this evening.
Yes, and right now they've been focusing a lot on their passing. Coach Flory has them doing specific drills in practice. Kylie Murr is back in the libero position to really help steady out that passing.
She was out last time around. For the first time this season, she missed a match, but they're so happy to have her back. And she has to try and dig Leah Edmond today on the outside.
Yes, and Leah is a force. She is had 21 kills and hitting 450 in her last match against Grand Rapids. She is explosive in the front row and in the back row, hits that BIC really well. That 1.5 set has such great arm speed and takes off from the back row. She's great on her block, great timing, is an impact player, fantastic volleyball player, and is a competitor and a force to be reckoned with.
You saw there off the number one kills player in the entire league, Leah Edmond, and Vegas looking for more consistency on the other side. One player, though, who has been consistent has been in the middle, Berkeley Oblak.
Berkeley, absolutely. She has been great in the front row, hitting that slide. She's consistent, well-respected, on and off the court. Does a great job offensively of finding space. And with her block, she has been stepping up and working on a split step and doing a really good job closing the block.
Oblad has really filled the gap nicely with Molly McCage still out. She has an illness that she's dealing with right now, so not even on the bench today, but still no timetable for Molly McCage's return. But as a team, Vegas has had some time off. They're feeling optimistic and now going to be put to the test against first place Atlanta. Should be a fun one tonight here in Lee's Family Forum. Vegas looking for their second home win of the season. Can they upset the first place team to get it? We'll find out straight ahead.
Gear up with the official Pro Collection apparel today. Available exclusively at RenAthletics.com and ProVolleyballShop.com.
NCAA women's volleyball will never be the same. Students of the game will study this era for generations. But we're only getting started. Sign up for pre-sale, news, and more at ncaa.com/volleyball.
From club or high school courts to championship arenas, Spalding has been the trusted partner of volleyball players for generations. Our team of dedicated professionals isn't just about selling equipment, we're about supporting your journey. Spalding offers a comprehensive range of high-performance systems, nets, and accessories meticulously crafted for every skill level, budget, and playing style. Whether you're a seasoned pro or just starting out, Spalding's knowledgeable staff will guide you, equip you, and cheer you on every step of the way.
Pro Volleyball Federation, where every action carries the weight of passion and pride. There's a select group that rises above the rest. 23 athletes of the Pro Volleyball Federation are past or current members of the USA Women's National Volleyball Team. Each a testament to dedication, skill, and relentless pursuit of excellence. Pro Volleyball Federation, building champions and making dreams a reality.
Once again, really grateful to have you with us here on this Monday night in Henderson, Nevada. AJ Cannell alongside Kirsten Olsen tonight, who played Division II ball at Cal State LA and in the AVP for 8 years. And it's the Atlanta Vibe visiting the Vegas Thrill. The Vibe at 12-4, first place in the Pro Volleyball Federation. And this is the group that they are going with tonight. It's Lekator Member-Mena and Leah Edmond on the outside. Anna Lazareva at opposite. Shelly Fanning. Magda Yelahasheva in the middle. The setter is Marley Montserre. And it's Morgan Hentz at libero, if you've heard of her. Magda Yelahasheva, she had her first career start in this building against Vegas and came up with a huge effort. She had four blocks and hit 444 with 10 kills. She has 11 blocks in the two matches against Vegas overall and has become already, as a rookie, one of the best blocking middles in the league. For Vegas, Hannah Maddox and Gabby Gonzalez on the outside, with Gonzalez returning to the lineup tonight. Kat Bell at opposite, Lane Van Buskirk and Berkeley Oblad in the middle. Alicia Glass-Childress at center, and Kylie Murr is the libero. Great libero matchup tonight, but take a look now at Alicia Glass-Childress, who has to carry a huge burden, as we know, for this offense.
Yes, and she leads the league in assists, 630, and sometimes we forget that she's a Penn State national champion in 2007, 8, and 9, and played for the legendary Russ Rhodes. She's an Olympian, won a bronze medal in Rio in 2016, but she is the leader of her team, has to teach up some young pins on the outside, and has an extremely high volleyball IQ.
She is like a coach on the court, but the actual head coach for Vegas is Fran Flory, the Texas alum, class of 84, won an AIAW national title for the University of Texas in 1981. She is going up against Todd Dagenet, who is leading the way for the Atlanta Vibe, was the head coach at UCF for 15 years. As a player, he was a four-year club team member at Central Michigan. Keys to the game. I love this when the coaches agree on what the keys are.
Yes, definitely from the Thrill side, the block, contesting the block at the net, sealing the line, staying at home on the Bix that Leah Edmond is so good at hitting. She does a great job. And then for the Vibe, all about chemistry, but all about offense and getting past that block and to the defense. Be unpredictable and get to that defense in the back row that Thrill has been struggling with.
Yeah, so I mean, you had one head coach tell us, you know, in terms of Atlanta, like we have to get it by their block. And then the other head coach say, well, we have to contain Atlanta's hitting at the level of the net. And so, great to see when you have that type of simpatico between the two coaches, you know, at least agreeing on something. As Gabby Gonzalez will serve it away. And we are underway here in Henderson. Lazareva tips on her first attack of the night. Now, member Mena just rifles one off the block for an Atlanta 5 point.
Yeah, I love to see her aggressive, going high hands on that block right off the bat.
She has established herself as the 0-2 as the season has gone along.
Yeah, I really respect someone that at 5'7 that can play at this level and get so many touches at the net.
Well, there is Oblad as advertised for Vegas. Fran Flory loves her efficiency on the slide.
Yeah, nice job by Childress putting Oblad right in that money spot on the slide. No glad taking advantage of it.
It'll be Lazareva back to serve out of Russia. Tight pass there. Glass-Childress handles it. Maddox with the swing. Some contact netted. Murr back in the lineup today after a knee injury sidelined her against Omaha. Morgan Hentz answers with a dig of her own. Yelahasheva on the slide attempt. Out of system, Maddox looking for contact. and doesn't get the call. And that'll take us to our first challenge of the night. Didn't take long to get one. Fran Flori says, cue the replay.
Not sure if I saw a touch on that, but it happened pretty fast.
You know, if there was one, you would think that the Vegas bench would have had a really great angle of it, considering where Maddox was attacking from, but we will see how it goes. It's an interesting thought, though, just in general. Fran was really harping on with the outsides, the young outsides on this team. All three of them are rookies, Maddox, Gonzalez, and Sauer. They have to be okay with keeping the ball in play and not going for the most difficult shot all the time.
Yeah, and high hands is a great place to go, and that was exactly what Hannah Maddox was trying to do, try to get some fingertips on the way out, especially in a transition play. Oh, I see a finger moving. Ooh. Maybe I don't.
Yeah, because it almost looked like it was the, I think that was it Monterey? It almost looked like her finger was bending back, but actually it was the flick follow through that you were seeing from Maddox. So no block touch.
That's why we got the expensive cameras.
Bolt 6 technology already coming in handy. Here's Maddox, a chance for redemption. And she delivers. 3-2 in the first set after Hannah Maddox is in the stat sheet.
And that's a great swing by Maddox. Not intimidated that she just hit the ball out. Still goes high, line over the setter, down the line.
Good pass by member Mena. And there's that pick. Kylie Murr ready for Leah Edmond. Maddox, though, is stuffed by Yelahasheva. We just saw a couple of strengths from these two teams, the Bick, then the dig by Murr, and then the Yelahasheva block. You're seeing it all on that point.
Yeah, and Yelahasheva does such a great job at the net blocking. Really great timing.
Bell tries to swipe it down. Here she comes again. The wall is up against Bell. And is short on that attempt.
And you know what I love about Yelahasheva? She does in the front row is she really times it well with her setter. I saw her talking to her, making sure she's waiting and penetrating at the right time.
Todd Dagenet saying it's been a pleasure working with her because she's one of the best blockers that he has ever worked with, and that she has an innate sense for just where the ball is going to go. They gave up Allison Bastianelli and Kendra Dahlke, traded them to San Diego for the number 2 overall pick, which was Magda. And they brought in Yelahasheva.
Yeah, good addition to the team, absolutely.
Took her a few weeks to get going. He said that was just to get the chemistry going. There's a brand new player out of college with a new setter, and she's been an outstanding player since then. As see, a double was called there. Interesting. Todd Dagenet doesn't agree with this. Neither does the rest of the team.
Yeah, I'm not sure about that. Let's see, that's, I don't know that. So she.
Where was the double?
Yeah, yeah. That's.
I don't get that.
Yeah, on the third contact. I don't know. Judgment call.
It had to have been on the third contact. Mm-hmm. Certainly the second contact was just kind of a bop over.
Yeah.
To use the technical term.
Right.
As Gonzalez
good
swings. Yeah, that's right. Really bringing the high-level terminology to you. As
bop.
Edmund.
Yes.
Brings down the hammer there.
Yeah, she has such range. Nice dig there by Mena. And, oh, such a great sharp angle swing by Edmund.
Oblad covers her own as Monterey has that ricochet right back over to Murr. Swatted back over. Oblad on the attack, dug by member Mena. Here is Edmund, and she is stuffed. I think that was Bell there. It was her and Oblad combining.
Yes, and talking to Coach Flori before the match, they are going to take away the line of the outside hitters of the Vibe, and Kat Bell did a great job closing, keeping the seam closed on that one.
setting middle and fanning. She misses wide, so Vegas comes up with a couple in a row. One of the biggest strengths for Atlanta is their passing. Here's Gonzalez, tries to hammer it through the block. Gets another chance, and this time goes off hands and out.
And a nice swing guy, Gabby Gonzalez, not afraid of a block in her face. Using the block on that, tooling the outside, actually the inside hound of Lazare on that one.
Back set here to Edmund. Maddox digs, keeps it in play, but Lazareva ends the play.
Yeah, she is such a cagey veteran. She really has every shot in the book. Such a high volleyball IQ. Such a smart player.
In her 10th year as a pro out of Moscow. Overpass, and that was smartly done by Shelley Fanning, fifth year pro out of Baylor.
Yeah, nice job at the net with that directional block. That's the quickest way to get rid of it. Just throw it down.
And Edmund dials up an ace. She went short there. Fran Flory talked about the serving velocity for Atlanta and how they're wary of that. Edmund giving a different look on that serve. And 3-0 run, answering the 3-0 run.
Yeah, mixing it up, pushing Gabby Gonzalez to pass that one.
Here's Gonzalez ISO'd against Lazareva, but she missed it.
Gabby Gonzalez really likes to hit that line, which is something I really like to see, but that one just turned a little too sharp.
Fran saying her outsides, they're getting so much better, but they're all rookies, and it's going to have to be a growing up process for them as Hannah Maddox steps up with a back row attack there.
Yeah, and I like that play. That's a great, nice pass, first of all, by Gonzalez, and mixing it up a little bit, setting the back row on that one.
Giving Leah Edmund and company a dose of their own medicine. Lazareva fits it through a seam. Bell digs. Montserrat sets Member Mena. Good tempo there in that set, and Member Mena was ready to deliver a kill.
Yeah, she does a nice job hitting those fast sets and beating the block on that one.
That's a huge strength as well for Atlanta, just the chemistry they have as an entire team, but especially setter to hitter with tempo. They are able to beat that block a lot of the time.
Yeah, and that was something that they've had from the beginning, great chemistry, and the coach says that that's something that counts for at least 2 or 3 points in a set.
Van Buskirk block touch against Yelahasheva. Back set, D ball, Bell. There is Morgan Hentz. Oh, tight pass, doesn't matter, as Glass Childress knew what to do with it.
Yes, she did. There's the cagey veteran move. Sees that opening on the floor. Dumps it away.
A little tight off the free ball, and Glass Childress just said, you know what, I'll take care of this. But Edmund answers back. Okay, what makes her so good at the BIC?
Well, she's fast, and she's explosive, and she's got really, really good timing, and she's got that fiery sense about her. And she literally, I've seen her, you know, crush balls on the right side, too. So she literally can hit anywhere on the court.
That was crushed on the right side, a slide kill for Lane Van Buskirk, who we were told by Fran Flory is going to be on her way out soon for VNL tryouts. She is from Windsor, Ontario, will be going out for Team Canada.
Oh, nice, yeah. Love to see her get going offensively.
For now, there's still a crucial role for her without the cage in the lineup. Yelahasheva answers one of her own.
Yeah, nice job by Yelahasheva on that slide. Finding the seam in the block.
High school basketball star Member Mena serves. Now Bella left side swing, and that was way off the mark. There was a first row fan that may have been come under fire from that swing by Kat Bell, but looks like they're all right, and Atlanta is off to a solid early start, 15-11. Welcome back, 15-11 Atlanta in the first set. What a great libero matchup this is. Kylie Murr against Morgan Hentz. You've probably heard of both of those names, and of course the top two in digs per set in the PVF. No surprises there.
Yes, and one of the game plans is to keep the ball away from Morgan Hentz, which is a hard thing to do.
Also, a breaking news, a huge surprise, Fran Flori. Yeah, we need to not let her touch it. And particularly when you can most control that is on the serve. So we want to focus on where Vegas is serving the ball, because they're trying not to serve Hentz. They have a lot of great passers on Atlanta, but they don't want Hentz touching it. And that was a great serve by Maddox targeting member Mena. And Maddox lays out one arm dig. Here's Gonzalez looking to pay it off. Tip from the back row swing by member Mena. Off the block and all the way down. Kill for Gonzalez.
Yeah, and a good heads up play by the Thrill with Alicia Glass-Childress digging a ball. Someone else stepping in to set that ball. Nice heads up play.
Serving Hentz there, great pass. And Yelahasheva converts. So you see kind of the two sides of it. You target member Mena successfully, bad pass, point Vegas, and the next point they serve right into Hentz.
Yeah, and that's, you know, who you don't want to serve.
There it is. You're going to get sided out very quickly if you serve Hentz. And on the other side, it's kind of the same thing. Vegas wants to target their serve receive toward Murr as much as possible. Gonzalez also carried a big load this year on serve receive. Good block touch against Lazareva, but the timing wasn't there between Glass-Childress and Van Buskirk.
Yeah, a little bit of a miscue there on that 31. Just missed it.
It's the proverbial announcer saying, though, now you're playing a team like Atlanta, you can't afford those little mistakes, right?
No, you cannot.
Against the first place team. We all know this. Bell. Great dig there by Lazareva on a solid cross-court hit. In the back, they've gone Maddox a couple of times behind the attack line. Nice set there, and Edmund disposes of it. Monterey with a prime time set.
Yes, and that fast outside set to the antenna. That is Edmund's money right there, just exposing that line that Kat Bell gave her.
That is where Vegas wants to prevent Atlanta from going. They know the vibe, like to crush it right down the line.
It's finally over. A concept years in the making becomes a reality tonight. We have stars that are sure to make a splash in terms of heads.
There are stars everywhere you look.
No secret that tonight's gonna be epic.
Prepare to make history. And we are underway. And what a start. And a serve for Wiley. Picks out Donna Miller.
Just so.
For
From club or high school courts to championship arenas, Spalding has been the trusted partner of volleyball players for generations. Our team of dedicated professionals isn't just about selling equipment, we're about supporting your journey. Spalding offers a comprehensive range of high-performance systems, nets, and accessories meticulously crafted for every skill level, budget, and playing style. Whether you're a seasoned pro or just starting out, Spalding's knowledgeable staff will guide you, equip you, and cheer you on every step of the way.
As you take a look at Fran Flory and her staff on the transaction wire today, Vegas waiving their first round pick, Hannah Pukis calling up Maddie Schermerhorn to the active roster. And I know a lot of people with reactions to that transaction. Fran just saying, look, she didn't want to comment much on it, but just saying that, look, it was an amicable and mutual split between the two sides. There's clearly no role right now for Pukis on Vegas with Alicia Glass-Childress, and that's kind of where we're at right now with that. Of course, Atlanta also no longer has its first round pick. And so it's one of those things. It's tough in this league. You know, sixth overall pick, Chiamaka and Woklo was waived by Atlanta and claimed and waived by a couple of other teams. And of course, both of these teams have hit on some other transactions and in Vegas's case, picks that were later on during the draft. It's
well, when you find your setter, you got to go with her.
Yeah, you give some and you get some as Gonzalez brings it down. As the Thrill try and claw their way back into this first set.
Nice job by Gonzalez, another good pass, and finding that seam in the block and going thumbs down and hitting that hard angle.
Yeah, Fran did tell us, by the way, when we had the call with her before the match, like we usually do, that if she could go back and, you know, redraft their draft, like, she might change a thing or two, but they're also really proud of a couple of the picks they've made. And that's probably how it's going to be for every team. And also, again, feels like there's an extremely bright future for Pukis, and it really has nothing to do with her ability, the fact that she's been hurt most of the year, and they have Alicia Glass-Childress on their team. As Maddox kills for Vegas.
And Maddox doing a nice job in the back row, hitting that kind of in between a, I think that's, let's see. Yeah, that's a pipe. Pipe pick. We'll call it a pick.
Split the difference.
Yeah.
Crucial service error, though, to create more distance for the Vibe. Serving and passing, that's been an issue all year. As Coach Flory is well aware of and has discussed with the commentary team. Oblad, though, has not been the issue this season.
Yeah, she is on a pogo stick on that slide. Taking off on one foot is her specialty. She makes it look so easy.
She said that Oblad is the stabilizing force, not just on the court, but really in life for a lot of these younger players.
Yeah, very respected on and off the court. It's a good person to have on your team.
It's like they know we're talking about them with the missed serve.
Oh, yeah, 100%. That happens every time. You say something nice and they miss the serve.
Over the shoulder there, Glass-Childress feeling herself on that setter dump.
Yeah, she's been there before. She knows all the spots on the court. Great time to throw out a little veteran move. A little dump over the shoulder and a little shoulder shimmy.
Yeah.
Like that.
She enjoyed that. And off the block, covered by Montserrat. Here's Bell. Lazareva, Glass-Childress. Hentz says, yeah, I can dig it too. Don't forget, member Mena. And a point for Vegas. Out was the call. Todd Dagenais looks like he's getting ready to challenge this for a block contact. And this has been challenged. It's so great, the speed with which they solve these in the NCAA.
Oh, I 100% agree.
You have to think about the line judge call. You have to think about taking a look at different angles on the block touch, all of that. Now, we know right away on every point whether it's in or out in terms of a line. And then usually it's also sorted much quicker up top as well with this Bolt 6.
This is a beautiful thing. I call a lot of NCAA matches, and it takes 20 minutes, I swear. So this is wonderful. Love this.
People want to complain about the Bolt 6 references, but it's saving y'all time. Let's not forget.
Oh, I definitely see a pinky moving.
In that case, yeah, I think you're right. I think Atlanta's going to win this challenge after Vegas lost a block touch challenge earlier in the set. That is a big two-point swing.
But in that rally, some great defensive plays by Glass Childress and some nice transition plays. That was a close one.
It is now, of course, April, in the month of March, when the Thrill were 2-5 overall. They were 0-7 in first sets. They have not won a first set since February, as Maddox with a deep cross and hits the back corner.
And Hannah Maddox is on fire right now, really doing well offensively. But she's got four kills, five?
She's off to a 4-for-10 okay. start with four digs. Nice. As Lazareva is roofed by Van Buskirk. It's 23-20.
That blocking scheme is working. Closing that line. Nice close by Van Kirk as well.
Overpass off the Maddox serve. Childress back set, a good one for Bell. One arm heads. Bell pulls the string. Hentz was right there for it, but Yelahasheva was also ready. Now trying Van Buskirk, and Yelahasheva shuts the door.
Yeah, that was a little bit of a forced middle set and too low.
Well, it's almost like they knew she couldn't go to Bell again. And Yelahasheva was aware of where that set was going. Set point coming.
Pro Volleyball Federation.
We're going to learn a lot more about who ultimately is going to make it to the championships in mid-May right here in Omaha.
That's a back row attack for Amelia Dimitrova.
Out of the row again.
Yes!
For a nigh. They called her adorable at the beginning, but yeah. She's just an assassin.
Terrifying.
Dimitrova roots. Lane Van Buskirk. And Scott puts the game away.
Pro Volleyball Federation, where every action carries the weight of passion and pride. There's a select group that rises above the rest. 23 athletes of the Pro Volleyball Federation are past or current members of the USA Women's National Volleyball Team. Each a testament to dedication, skill, and relentless pursuit of excellence. Pro Volleyball Federation, building champions and making dreams a reality.
Washington State University phenom and rookie number 2 overall pick Magda Yelahasheva has the serve on set point. Handled by Maddox, shoved by Gonzalez, 4 point.
And this makes me really happy to see these young pins. Their biggest struggle has been their shot selection. They're doing a great job moving the ball around, different speeds, and that was a great shot by Gabby Gonzalez there.
They will give Vegas a chance here to try and get on a run on their serve. It is Megan Jemison who filled in for Murr last match at Libero. Has to win 3 on her serve. Here's Edmund for the set. Block right back down, but almost inadvertently covered off a deflection, it looked like. Member Mena with the dig. Here's Edmund. Oh, you can't give her another chance. I want to go back and see a replay of that when we get a chance. I don't know how that one stayed in the air. We're going to take a look here going into the break. Atlanta outlasts Vegas in the first set, 25-21. As we take a look at how was this kept up. Let's see. Oh, we're going to see how the point ended there. Atlanta after the first set, so now do it all over again, and talk about the importance of the first contact.
Yeah, and definitely the vibe has been doing a nice job in the back row, really covering their block well and creating opportunities for their offense to score. And kills across the board pretty evenly for all of their hitters, so that means that Monterrez is doing a good job distributing the ball around.
That passing percentage, just a huge differential, and not unexpected when you take into account how good of a passing team Atlanta has been all year, and it has been an issue for Vegas most of the year. Every single one of Atlanta's passers, every player they use in their serve receive, would be the best statistical passer on Vegas in terms of the raw numbers we get this year in positive passing percentage. Now, probably the reality is Murr is a better passer than their outsides, but just that their numbers are so good across the board for Atlanta. And that's a nice little second ball over there from Marley Montserrat.
Yeah, Montserrat showing that she can dump too. Takes a look at the court, sees that no man's land open, and dumps it over.
Member Mena chooses to tip Bell, and Glass Childress keep it alive. Penn says, I'll take this free ball,
yes.
And Monterey. Her head coach says she limits the toxic energy on the floor.
Yes.
They avoid any toxicity with the help of Monterey, who always keeps it light. Doesn't hurt when you can dump it like that as well.
And also look at Hens calling people off, taking that free ball. She runs the show back there defensively.
That was out off of Van Buskirk, and Fran Flory thinks there was a block touch there. And again, you cannot challenge in out. We already know whether it was in and out based on that replay. They're challenging block touch.
And I don't know how it is here, but I know in college the coaches sometimes do that to slow down the momentum. Let's challenge a call, kind of like a little timeout in a way.
Well, in my opinion, you're incentivized to do that here because you get two per set.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, even if you run out in a set, you're going to get two more fresh ones. And even if you miss this one right now, you still have a chance to
yep.
have that next one later in the set, and you'll still hold on to possession of that as long as you win the challenge.
Yeah.
So you have lots of opportunities to challenge calls, to keep challenges if you make them. And if you want to slow the game down a little bit, there's no reason not to.
Oh, absolutely. Yep, it's a good way to ice the server, good way to regroup, talk about it, listen to some great music.
Now, she came out pretty quick, though, Fran did. We're listening to Jeopardy
okay.
music right now
know,
in this building.
Right? That's what I was saying.
But I think Fran was pretty certain with how quick, I was going to say, with how quick she challenged that she saw something. Oh, I thought I see maybe that middle finger scraping
yeah.
there. Yeah. They
no.
had to go back and look again
okay.
last time in Frisco. And I don't know that they got that right.
Double challenge? Yeah.
I don't know that they got that right. They should take another look. Fran can't believe it. You know, the last match we did, they had to go back and look again and overturned the overturn, so to speak. They're not going to do that here. That was close, but I thought there was a touch. And they were all looking up at the Jumbotron and thinking the same thing as Bell misses. And this is danger zone right now for the Thrill. Regardless of what you think of that one call, Thrill have to turn this thing around.
Yeah, they do. And unforced errors right now is plaguing them. They need to get a kill.
Really interesting, Fran telling us how they worked on their passing with their 9 days off. She said they wanted to get the creative juices flowing, take the pressure off, work on passing the ball and have it hit yourself in the head. Can you pass and hit a garbage can? Can you pass it behind you? You know, just show these players they're capable of controlling the ball and take the pressure off. So they were putting targets all over the gym and not just doing this, you know, the basics passing drills that they're accustomed to.
Yeah, and opening up that creativity and feeling a little more loose with it and not get the pressure off the young pins in their passing.
A kill for Bell.
Yeah, she needed that one. Nice swing by Bell.
She hit negative last time. Trying to get off to a better start today as that's hit down the line hard by Member Mene. A Member Mena, they changed that on me from last time. Say it's now Lekator Member Mena.
Oh, yeah. Took advantage of that line. Cat Bell gave her a little bit, and she took it.
And Buskirk blocked. Atlanta off to a really nice start here in set two, not letting up.
Yelahosheva does such a good job in the front row, really reads those quicks well.
Hannah Maddox, the rookie fourth round pick out of South Alabama. Went with Maddox and Gonzalez today as the outsides. Kenneth Sowers also been playing pretty well, but they said after some more in-depth statistical analysis that they feel like their chances are best right now, with Gonzalez and Maddox getting the starting nod on the outside, but Gonzalez runs into a wall there.
Yep, that was a pretty big wall. I don't think she had a way out of that one.
The setter,
right,
Monsere.
Yes.
Off the combination, big block touch against Gonzalez. Timing wasn't really there on the slide, so fanning into the net.
Yeah, it looks like a little miscommunication there with Fanning and Monsere.
It's been rare for Atlanta this year. And this is as advertised. Atlanta likes to hit line. Fran Flori this week determined to try and take that away, but easier said than done.
And you know, it's also hard when you're going over the block, and she just hits so fast and so hard. Gets the inside hand, a cat bell, pulls it out.
Trying to tuck it through the seam right there, get the inside hand, and she did. They really cut it down the line a lot, and now Bell is blocked. All vibe. The vibes are all positive here for Atlanta in this second set, as Hippe is going to come in for Bell.
And there's just nowhere to go there. Edmund doing such a good job pressing at the right time on that block.
Fran Flori has been saying that Hippe has been ramping up lately. Well, she's banged up for a while, not able to really stay in there and play full matches, kind of a partial player. But now the last few days, Hippe's been ramping up. So she comes in for the struggling Bell at the moment. Kill there for Gonzalez.
Yeah, nice job by Gonzalez. Short tip in the middle of the court. And Hippe brings a little bit different game to the right side, has a lot of offense, a lot of experience playing internationally. See what she can bring to the table.
Free ball here for Atlanta. Clips the tape, Fanning. Now Gonzalez, the block has been there for the vibe. Is pushed over by Gonzalez. Monsere. Wow. Was that almost a slide
that
kill
a
for
slide.
Edmund? But it was kept up by Vegas. What a point this is.
This is the creativity of the vibe.
Oh, man. Edmund, have yourself a point.
Go ahead. Hit a slide. Go ahead. Block on the right. I mean, she can play anywhere. Oh, my goodness.
Yeah, I was trying to believe my eyes in the middle of that point as I saw Leah Edmund take a slide approach. And we have a timeout. Atlanta on top of Vegas. Look at the reaction there. 12-6 in the second.
NCAA women's volleyball will never be the same. Students of the game will study this era for generations. But we're only getting started. Sign up for pre-sale news and more at ncaa.com/volleyball. Looking like a baddie, I show up and make them stop.
Wanna know my name so badly, cause I run this whole block. Gear up with the official Pro Collection apparel today. Available exclusively at renathletics.com and Pro Volleyball Shop.
Head coach Todd Dagenais says that Leah Edmond, she compares to some of the greatest athletes across all different sports with her competitive mindset.
100%. She is, when she gets in rhythm, she is hard to stop. He actually described her also as demonstrative.
You know, said that you kind of have the quiet leadership out there, competitiveness of Monterey with the more demonstrative competitive fire from Edmond. Atlanta on the verge of making this set to a blowout. Now Hippe gets a swing. Edmond digs. Maddox the dig for Vegas. Hippe pulls the string. Morgan Hentz not going to work against her. Edmond had to wait on that approach. On the over dig, member Mena.
Nice job by member Mena at the net. A couple of good swings here, some nice defense by the Thrill, but member Mena says enough of that. I'm putting this ball away.
Oblad has to pass that serve, and she says, they'll do that, and then go and crush a slide.
Now, that is not an easy thing to do, and that was, she was served on purpose to try to bring her out of her game, and good for her. She nailed that seam. Fanning was late on that block, too.
Message received there. Member Mena sending one of her own. Member Mena played collegiately at both Pittsburgh and Missouri, and she helped take Pittsburgh to their first Final Four in program history. She didn't cross paths quite with Lane Van Buskirk, who was there previous years. But a couple of Pitt Panthers here in the building tonight. See how close this was.
Oh, that's so nice.
You're liking that. We've got you sold on bolt six. Out of system here. Lasareva with the power. Coach Dagenais said they could easily set her 50 times if they wanted to, but they just have to kind of resist the will because they want to preserve her for May.
Yes, and she is an Olympian from the Russia, for Russia in the 2020 Olympics.
The ROC.
Yes, ROC, sorry. High-level volleyball. She's played a high-level volleyball in China and Turkey, has great game experiences, has a lot of lessons that she teaches some of the younger players about how to take care of their body.
Yeah, we asked about her, and coach was like, she's just the most experienced on the team by leaps and bounds. There are things that she's just able to show people just in terms of her off time routine, and that kind of how you conduct yourself in your off time really translates to what you're like on the clock. And she's teaching the younger members of the team about that. Meanwhile, it's 16-9 here in the second set. Atlanta's put up a big block in this second set. Pinballs around. Off of Murr and then Glass Childress, but now Edmond with a swing. Van Buskirk says no.
That's a big block at the net by Van Buskirk. And Hippe there lining that up and taking away that hard angle of Edmond.
Contact, no. Todd Dagenais walking over. And they're going to ask. We've had block touch challenges galore. It is definitely the most, most common challenge because there are no in-out challenges. I thought I might have heard a little extra ricochet sound, but maybe I was hearing things.
And I don't know if I've seen Leah Edmond hit a ball out yet. She always goes for hands. Hands or hard in the court.
That's good. It's that'd be a good like either defense attorney or prosecutor argument there. The evidence suggests that Leah Edmond does not hit very many balls out.
Let's see.
Atlanta's
won. She has zero errors.
Atlanta has won a block touch challenge already. Does this hit the index finger? It does.
Yep. She has no hitting errors. Continues. 17 swings.
She doesn't miss.
Yeah, she doesn't miss. She goes for hands or court.
She has been. She's been blocked a couple of times.
She has.
But no pure errors. Yep, he even had it down to the finger.
Case closed.
...17-11 now after the missed serve. And Van Buskirk will be the server. Good short serve there, a low serve. Oh, they run the middle, and Shelly Fanning converts. Two-time U.S. Collegiate National Team member. Of course, Todd Dagenet, former Collegiate Women's National Team head coach, in addition to his long-time tenure at Central Florida. Great combination play roll, and it's put down by Gonzalez.
Great job by Oblad, pulling the blocker on that one, creating an opportunity for Gabby Gonzalez to hit line with no block.
Fanning's run into a couple in a row here for the Vibe.
Yep, that gap set is working. Fanning's doing a nice job getting up and available, and Monsari is doing a great job distributing the ball around.
Monterey is fourth in the PVF in assists per set. Glass Childress is second behind Tom Com of San Diego. As Gonzalez stacks up another kill, she has eight of them. And Gonzalez did lead the way despite the sweep loss against Atlanta on March 4th in this building. Gonzalez hit a season best 15 kills and hit 420 in that one. Oh, Fanning again.
The unstoppable gap right now. Unanswerable gap, too. Nice job again, just with a little bit of space, a little bit of a float set there. Fanning finding the floor.
Serving sub here, Allie Linehan, who is one of the starting outsides to begin the year. Still a very good option out there. Vegas, those sides out. There's some great fan support on the opposing side for Linehan, by the way. She has her grandparents here. They have big signs that they came from Maine to see her play. Now, I would have to politely ask the grandparents, why didn't you choose Grand Rapids? What a, quite a coincidence that they chose Vegas to see her play, but I'm sure they get to get a little Vegas in. Oh, man, as Yelahasheva immediately comes over to say, I'm sorry about that. That's the
sorry
reason.
Sorry, hit you in the face. Ouch, that's a six-pack right there.
Talk about welcome to the PVF Shermer horn right there.
Yeah, she'll remember that one. Maybe with a Franklin on her face.
And it's on the Vegas side and down. A big kill for Edmund. Vegas has called timeout, 22-14 Atlanta Vibe lead in this second set.
Baby, I'm a big deal, I got it like that. I did it again, who told you that I was finished? Fresh off the plane with a new mani pedi. My hair stay laid and you know I get paid. $100 bills, I got racks on the way. I'm making them big moves, I won't stay quiet. 5'6", but I feel like a giant. I got the sauce, I am the supplier. I can make them boys sing like the inner choir. I'm on top and I'm taking it higher.
Not a tie. Sydney Hill and Jack Bass.
There are the great supportive grandparents there for Allie Linehan, who made the trip all the way from Maine. Cool to have them here, and framed signs.
Wow.
I like it.
Wonder how they got those through security.
I mean, look, we're here with Allie, right? It's right on the sign.
And she's getting some playing time, too, which is even better.
She was the inaugural PVF Player of the Week.
Nice.
All the way back in week one. She's been on IR multiple times, and when they need to, you know, sub in some ball control, Todd loves the depth of Atlanta and feels like they can bring her in. They have other options, too, off the bench whenever necessary for different potential needs. And the fact that she's kind of their third outside right now shows the depth. The former Kentucky national champion, as Hippe converts.
See if Hippe can get some offense going on the right. Change it up a little bit.
They're also great, by the way, the signs. They've just continued to hold the signs up the entire match so far. It's not like, oh, we might see a camera, now we're going to put them up. Like, they're just sitting there watching the match with the signs up.
Dedication.
Yeah. I want everyone to know, as member Mena misses wide. See, they're just like, we are sporting it.
Yep. It's a good thing they use poster board.
Yeah, that makes it easier.
Like the heat, Maddox is putting on that serve.
Lazareva, those sides out for Atlanta, and the Vibe have a boatload of set points. As we will see Whitney Bauer come in, making just her fifth set appearance of the season. Bauer was Atlanta's second round pick. As Vegas is still alive here in the set, kill for Hippe. That will do it. That will do it. And Shelly Fanning had a great second set for Atlanta. And she comes up with her fifth kill of the night on 11 swings. It was all Atlanta in the second, and the first place team is looking like it right now here on this Monday night in Vegas. We'll see if the thrill can come up with some type of turnaround after this.
NCAA women's volleyball will never be the same. Students of the game will study this era for generations. But we're only getting started. Sign up for pre-sale news and more at ncaa.com/volleyball.
Out, not a Miller.
Just so
bucket. It is 80s night here in Vegas, and we'll see a little bit of such a thing as air guitar. I don't know what you would consider this. I guess just fake guitar here during the set break. As let's get to the interview. Kirsten just catching up moments ago with Todd Dagenet.
I'm here with Coach Dagenet. How do you feel how your team's playing so far?
I think we're scrapping. I think it's a game we're not really in rhythm right now. Still finding ways to score, though. I think our block is touching balls. Our defense is doing a nice job of picking up, and we're transitioning quick. I think we need to keep going in the middle there. I feel like there's gaps there that we can hit. They're worried about the outsides right now. So it's a good idea if we can run somewhere between the two outside hitters right now. But how do we close out the match? I just think we stick to our game plan. We keep serving tough. We're missing serves. That's okay. I think we're putting them on defense with our serves. So I think that's a good thing.
Thanks, Coach.
Well, you know what? Atlanta, despite a few of those missed serves, they've been playing the right notes, so to speak, through the first two sets. The vibe right now in control against the thrill in the long set break.
Gear up with the official Pro Collection apparel today, available exclusively at RenAthletics.com and ProVolleyballShop.com.
NCAA women's volleyball will never be the same. Students of the game will study this era for generations. But we're only getting started. Sign up for pre-sale news and more at NCAA.com/volleyball.
From club or high school courts to championship arenas, Spalding has been the trusted partner of volleyball players for generations. Our team of dedicated professionals isn't just about selling equipment, we're about supporting your journey. Spalding offers a comprehensive range of high-performance systems, nets, and accessories meticulously crafted for every skill level, budget, and playing style. Whether you're a seasoned pro or just starting out, Spalding's knowledgeable staff will guide you, equip you, and cheer you on every step of the way.
Pro Volleyball Federation, where every action carries the weight of passion and pride. There's a select group that rises above the rest. 23 athletes of the Pro Volleyball Federation are past or current members of the USA Women's National Volleyball Team. Each a testament to dedication, skill, and relentless pursuit of excellence. Pro Volleyball Federation, building champions and making dreams a reality.
Five 21, 25-18. Atlanta on top of Vegas right now. Two sets to nothing. AJ Cannell, Kirsten Olsen. You just heard from Todd Dagenet there and kind of his thoughts, his mindset now going forward. What about Fran Flory here?
You know, I think that they're passing better, but I just feel like some of those transition plays, they're not converting like they should. I'm seeing some smart hitting by their pins, but they're really not taking advantage of any free balls. They're doing or committing a little bit too many unforced errors as well.
The reality is that it's just a different timeline right now. If you take a look at the stats and what we've seen through the first couple of sets, like Atlanta, the class of the league, one of the first franchises that was created, and Vegas was the seventh and final franchise up and running going into this year. So just a little bit tougher to get things going from a roster construction standpoint. That's definitely a part of it. And we're seeing two teams right now in different places. When you look at the numbers, Atlanta out hitting Vegas 329 to 149. Actually, Vegas's passing numbers looking pretty darn good, but the problem is Atlanta's passing numbers are absurdly good at the moment.
Absurdly better, and they're transitioning those passes into good hitting decisions. And Atlanta is ruling the net right now with the block, with seven blocks.
Yeah, that doesn't even take into account some of the block touches as well.
Yeah.
The block has been really good from the vibe. She is right in the middle there. She's kind of dressed for 80s night, I think it's fair to say. Atlanta up 2-0 over Vegas.
NCAA women's volleyball will never be the same. Students of the game will study this era for generations. But we're only getting started. Sign up for pre-sale, news, and more at ncaa.com/volleyball.
Spirits look pretty good right now for Vegas. Try and regroup after the long set break, down 2-0. AJ Cannell, Kirsten Olsen, our great crew led by producer Joe Kruger, Ted Spears doing it all on graphics and even more than that. And just a great overall production here in Vegas that we're all so thankful for. And the guys behind the scenes really get the credit. And Vegas looking to deliver more on the floor, just 1-6 at home this year compared to a 4-4 road record. Trying not to disappoint these home fans, but it's been a tough road so far this season for the Thrill, if we're being honest.
Yeah, they've got, you know, it's been a roller coaster of a season from them. Even Coach Flory said that, you know, it's focusing on the little things, starting with passing, which we're seeing improving a little bit tonight. But now it's getting that offense going, getting everybody going, and being able to transition some dug balls as well.
Well, Todd Dagenet said he thinks Vegas is one of the most improved teams in the league. He said if the season were longer, he thinks that Vegas would find a way to work itself into the playoff picture. He was also wary of the fact that Vegas had lost the first two meetings in this series and just thinking hard to beat a team three times. They do end up playing once more as well later this year in Atlanta. Played a home and home early March. Atlanta won the first 3-0 and took the second one 3-1. As Gonzalez gets us underway in the third. Fanning picking up where she left off in the second.
Yeah, and that's something that Coach Dagenet said he's going to work on, is getting those more middle sets going. And that's something that we saw them close out that last set and setting Fanning those gap sets and continuing to see that happen.
Well, Fanning recently had a 5-match stretch where she hit over 300 in all of those matches, including 560 with 10 kills against Columbus. Oblad running for this one. Matsure to Yelohasheva. This looks like a Thrill team right now that is trying to find some confidence against the first place team in the building.
Yep, confidence and the right recipe on the floor, right lineup, right communication, right chemistry.
Fran said, you know, just a lack of overall consistency. She thinks that Oblad's been fairly consistent. Mm-hmm. Murr and Glass Childress have been fairly consistent, but looking for more consistency elsewhere as Edmund lays out. Free ball here for Vegas. Maddox smacks it down. Coach acknowledged like it's been tough. She's had to yo-yo players at times, and she knows that's difficult on them, but she's also tried to give people the benefit of the doubt at times, and that hasn't always worked either. So they're just trying to find the right lineup, as you said. Childress dives, Yelahasheva off the block and down.
Yep, cleaning up that ball on their side of the net, coming up with good plays, good hittable sets, smart shots.
Yeah, meanwhile, Todd Dagenet just thinking chemistry is everything when it comes to his side, and they just have everything clicking. Eight of their last nine have been wins. Lazareva looking for maybe contact there, didn't find it.
Yeah, that's a rare hitting error for her. She's usually so scientific about where she puts the ball on the court. I think she was looking for hands on that one, you're right.
On the slide, cross-court swing for Yelahasheva. It's a three-match winning streak for Atlanta, plus the eight of nine. Even the three in a row in this league that's full of parity is the longest active winning streak right now in the PVF. Their last loss was at Columbus on March 24th. That comes right over our head there as Van Buskirk with the kill.
Yeah, I'd love to see her get going a little bit more in that front row, a little more explosive, get her some more sets.
Oh man, even on a pass like that, we're able to get it working with a one-handed set to Fanning.
Montserrat just has great chemistry with her team, and she almost wills her hitters to hit. All that positive energy she gives them.
Such a well-rounded player, Montserrat, with that beach experience as well, played collegiately indoors at Florida, on the beach, UCLA. And Fanning, have yourself an evening.
She has hit that spot way too many times. They need to take that away from her, that cutback.
Previously played professionally in Puerto Rico and Poland, and now Fanning enjoying the U.S. pro scene, the PVF in its first year. Fanning hitting 7-for-13 tonight. Hippe with the hitting error for Vegas. Just the body language right now, the energy just not there for Vegas. The last home match against Grand Rapids, they lost 3-1, nearly extended that match to five. They really were grinding through things, and you could just see the energy. Maybe that'll give them something. Hippe.
Yes, Hippe. I could tell that she wanted that one back. That first one she hit out, and she not afraid to hit again. Take that line that Leah Edmund gave her. Hit right down it.
Fanning is unstoppable.
Yep, that is a different location. Yep, that one, thumbs down, hard cross court.
We're done with wash and rinse, and we're in the repeat stage with Fanning right now.
Yeah, well, a good thing the game plan was to set the middles, because that's exactly what they're doing.
She's up to 444, has nine kills. And a lot of that's been recent, you know, toward the tail end of the second set, now into the third for Fanning. Nice little creative cross court from Lazareva. Got some help from the tape.
Yeah, Lazareva has all the shots. She knows which ones she should hit, which ones she should shoot. Little off-speed shot on that one.
A lot of short serves from Edmund today. Even the balls that Hentz doesn't dig, they're somehow still impressive. She's right there. as she was underneath that previous cover, but Oblad terminates on the slide.
Yeah, I would love to see them get the ball to her more. She's so lethal on that slide. Great set by Glass Childress. Gets her out by the antenna so she can take advantage of that mismatch.
Well, it's a great point that it's amazing how much they're able to get the ball to the middles given some of their issues passing, as this is just perpetual at this point for Fanning. You know, and Fran gives Alicia a lot of credit for her ability to still set, you know, when she was in there, McCage and now Oblad and Van Buskirk, but it has made her life difficult though when you have a younger team with all these rookie outsides that have issues passing, as Pepe is roofed, and this has been kind of a bloodbath here so far tonight. As a timeout is called, Atlanta 11-6 on their way towards the sweep, but still time in the third.
NCAA women's volleyball will never be the same. Students of the game will study this era for generations. But we are only getting started. Sign up for pre-sale, news, and more at ncaa.com/volleyball. Looking like a baddie, I show up and make them stop. Wanna
know my name so badly, cause I run this whole block. Gear up with the official Pro Collection apparel today. Available exclusively at renathletics.com and Pro Volleyball Shop.
Things not going Vegas' way right now for Kylie Murr and company, but it is an outstanding libero matchup tonight with Murr against Morgan Hentz. And we're going to try and do something different here and open it up to the comments section and go with our first ever poll question. Okay, how do you pronounce libero? I go with libero, but might you go with libero instead? The poll is live right now. Let us know. We'll report back the results here.
Yeah, interesting to see. I'm a libero girl. That's what I go with. But I like to pronunciate all the syllables. So.
I will say, when I first got into this line of work, this very niche line of work, it was a point of contention and stress for a while. But I have since settled into libero, and I feel like most will, but some people feel very strongly the other way. And I think, you know what? What better time to do this than Morgan Hentz and Kylie Murr?
Absolutely. And I've asked Dane Blanton before, and he said it is libero, but it is.
There's some hardliners that would point out that it really is libero. So, you know, let's open it up. Poll is live. Back to live action. 12-7. Oh. Magda Yelahasheva with a middle kill. The middles have been outstanding tonight for Atlanta.
Really hitting cutbacks, wrists down, just everywhere. Really unstoppable in the middle. Vegas does not have an answer for them.
Well, Magda is at 6-20, 8 for 13, no errors. Fanning 10 for 17 with two errors, so 470. So the middle is combined hitting over 500. And Magda has four blocks. She now has 15 stuffs in the three matches against Vegas. As Edmund comes down with one as well.
Yeah. Another great swing by Edmund through the block on that one, and she does a nice job. If she's not getting all the kills, distracting other teams with her offense, so people are focusing on her and opens up the offense for her other players on the team.
Saskia Hippe came way too close for comfort to us on that point, but they stay in the point behind Hippe, and she and Maddox share an embrace.
And nice job by Maddox. I love the fire in her belly. Hitting hard line on that one, taking advantage of the mismatch.
It's your casual back four there as well. From Alicia Glass-Childress as Edmund comes down with the tip kill.
Yeah, she can set from anywhere on the court, dial it up exactly how any hitter wants it.
It's had to be a tough season, you would think, for Alicia Glass-Childress, but she's just been so crucial. Maybe the wins and losses, the results haven't always been there, but she's been bringing these younger players on the team along.
Yeah, and leading in assists still.
Yeah, still leads in total assists in the league. As Vegas will send Elaine Van Buskirk back to serve. They side out. Oblad back into the front row.
Yeah, we're seeing them come up with a couple of good plays in here and there, but really stringing those good plays together are how they're going to get back into being one of the top teams in the league.
There's an opportunity, and Oblad finds the mark.
And Oblad doing a nice job being creative on that one. Short tip.
Marley Montserrat mentioned her career in the indoor side of things at Florida. A couple of sisters also play there. She had to serve. Edmund puts it away. And it looked like maybe some signs of life momentarily for Vegas, but now 17 to 11.
Yeah, and a little just error on that pass by Gonzalez. She's passing two-thirds of the court. A lot of pressure on her.
Oh, Edmund. Edmund now with 11 kills.
Yeah, she is so bouncy and just so explosive on that ball.
Let's take a look at this one from Leah Edmund. One of the best outsides in the entire league.
With you, AJ Canell, Kirsten Olsen,
and likely wrapping things up pretty shortly, closing out the affairs in the third set with Atlanta up by 7 points, up by two sets, and looking to clinch the season series against Vegas and maintain their first place spot in the league by what would be a game and a half over Omaha. Oh man, after it was kept up heroically, a little miscommunication there. Let's take a look. An outstanding attempt there by Murr, which, speaking of Kylie Murr, we hear that libero is outpacing libero by a healthy margin. However, other has picked up a few votes as well, which I love.
What's other?
I don't know. Get creative with it. Libero.
Yeah, libero. Like a liger.
I don't know. I'm not sure, but we you had to put in other. Any poll, any good poll has to include other.
Libero?
There you go. That's other. That's officially other. As Hippe kills. And now we will see Madison Schermerhorn come in with Pukas being waved. Schermerhorn gets the call up. She is listed as a DS on the roster, will come in as a serving specialist here. She was drafted by the Thrill in the fifth round. Schermerhorn, now Gonzalez, another Thrill draft pick. A lot of rookies on this team by necessity due to their late creation. And the veteran Glass Childress ends the point.
Smart play by her. Nice covering, by the way, by Kylie Murr. Childress sees an open spot on the court. She can put it down too.
Back row attack. Hands digs Maddox. She'll be a free ball. Schermerhorn handles it. Oblad on the slide. Montserrat was waiting, so Hentz, who's a great second ball option, averages over an assist per set. Gonzalez, though, kills.
Great rally by both teams, but Gonzalez is able to find high hands again and go line.
See if Schermerhorn can get a service run going. After her collegiate career at Purdue, Edmonds, the Kentucky alumna, with the kill. Two-time SEC Player of the Year, four-time All-American, and delivering in the PVF just as much. Big thump from Oblad that was kept up. And off the block hard as it continues to be a great day for the entire attacking group, and that was Grace Cleveland. Atlanta mixing in some substitutes late. Now the grandparents get to see Allie Linehan play some front row.
They're down to one sign now.
I'm actually shocked at that development. The two were going strong. Oh man, Glass Childress, unbelievable just to even do that, to get it toward Gonzalez, even though Atlanta wins the point.
Yeah, setting from her knees, back set, just flick it back. She makes it look easy, and it's actually not.
Oblad with the kill. Coming up from Vegas, they're going to play at Grand Rapids on the 13th, and then back here at home for a little two-match homestand against Columbus and Grand Rapids, the 17th and the 20th, both 7 o'clock local start times. Atlanta will play at San Diego on Wednesday, so two matches in 3 days. They also had a long layoff coming into this one. Both teams very fresh coming in as Maddox has the hitting error there, but Atlanta, they go 2 of the next 3 days with a match. 3 in the next 6 days and 6 in the next 14. So buckle up for the vibe.
That's a lot. Rest your starters as much as you can.
Yeah, I mean, to have a start of that stretch with this, it's going to be an easy three-set win and can even take some players out here at the end of the third set. That's huge. as they try and maintain their first place spot over Omaha. Oblad has been a bright spot, as you would expect for Vegas.
She has. I'd love to see her just continue to get the ball to her. She's lethal on that slide.
She's hitting 7 for 14 with no errors.
I believe it.
Karis Watson in the game in the middle. She had some starting reps earlier in the season, as on the second attempt, Maddox puts away the remix version.
Recycle, reuse, use the block. Nice job by Maddox, being available and aggressive at the net.
Van Buskirk thumps down on the overpass.
Good job at the net by the middle blocker, taking care of that ball.
Okay, got to remember now, you have a bunch of reserves in for Atlanta. It's now 23-19. Watson is dug by Oblad, her counterpart. And that is out. Linehan misses. I thought maybe it was, I had the score messed up, I guess, before. Now it's 23-19. My apologies. But either way,
yeah,
against that second string lineup, a lot of players that Todd Dodgene says have been playing really well in practice, but all of a sudden you get the pressure here of the live game. Vegas trying to inch closer here in the third set. Timeout. Okay.
From club or high school courts to championship arenas, Spalding has been the trusted partner of volleyball players for generations. Our team of dedicated professionals isn't just about selling equipment, we're about supporting your journey. Spalding offers a comprehensive range of high-performance systems, nets, and accessories meticulously crafted for every skill level, budget, and playing style. Whether you're a seasoned pro or just starting out, Spalding's knowledgeable staff will guide you, equip you, and cheer you on every step of the way.
That you are averting any type of potential disaster.
It's not easy to come in to close out the match, especially when you've been watching the whole time. But like you said, they're pros. This is what they're supposed to do.
Still have Leah Edmond in there.
I think they're gonna set her a bit. That's my guess. Get me the ball.
Can Vegas get even closer? Pressure on some of these reserves, who you know are pros for Atlanta, but you got to imagine they're feeling some pressure right now, all of a sudden being thrust in this position, 23-20.
Feeling some pressure, feeling some nerves.
Edmond, I think she missed there. No block touch, that's out. This is now officially a set. She's up for grabs here, and Atlanta's gonna put their regulars back in, I think. Todd Dagenais. Oh no, they're gonna go and review this. They're gonna ask for a challenge.
Leah Edmonds seemed almost animate about that one. She wanted that challenge.
Member Mene was also working her way toward the substitution area as well, was what I was looking at. Then the buzzer sounded, which could signify either or a challenge or a sub. So we'll see if they, I mean, if you're Atlanta, would you give the players who you've put in the chance to close this thing out? Or at this point, do you just throw some people back in?
Man. That's tough. I don't know the members that he put in of their, you know, experience level so far this year, if they've been able to close out matches. I think
Watson's been a starter. Linehan's been a starter earlier in the year. Grace Cleveland's also in there. She's played at times.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I'd say leave them in. Trust your team. Trust the chemistry. If Leah made this error, this would be her second hitting error, if that. But she seems like she got some hands on that one.
She's been a pretty lengthy look here at this block touch challenge. We haven't seen anything yet from Bolt 6. You know what? I mean, you mentioned putting a stop to some momentum earlier on. This will also accomplish that. I do not think we see contact, though. No block touch. And the subs and the starters now re-entering.
Well, two of them are back in.
Told that Atlanta still has some substitutes left toward the eight-person limit. Uh-oh. As member Mena misses, it's down to one.
Wow.
Oh, man. An attack line fall. Everything going Vegas's way. They're on a hot streak right now. It's like you're at the slot machine, and you keep on getting the right numbers.
And who's that back there serving right now? Is old stabilizer Oblad. Oh, of course I said something nice about it. I'm sorry, I ruined that. I'll be quiet now.
It was a heck of a run. Yeah, it was a heck of a run. But the timing was too good.
Yeah.
It was an 8-0 run, 7 on Oblad serve, but a match point here still for Atlanta. Here is Maddox off the high set. Maddox off hands. Lazareva block, covered heads. Dumped over and down! Monterey! After all that, still Atlanta in three, but a challenge by Fran Flory. So let's not completely close the book yet.
Okay, I don't know what she's challenging. Well, we'll find out. Okay.
All right, well, at the end of the play, when a challenge comes in like that, the way the rule is, you can't go back earlier in a point and challenge something that happened prior to the conclusion. So that had to be on the final touch there.
So Monterey. Oh, okay.
I think there might have to be some clarification on what they're challenging here in terms of which potential attack line fault. Correction, they're challenging a net fault. Yeah, I mean, a tack line fault made no sense because you had a setter who was floor bound putting that over.
Confused there, yeah. So did she net when she was sending it over? I don't
think she was anywhere near the net, so that had to be somebody else.
Oh, okay, all right.
I mean, we can get a replay here. We'll see it soon. But my recollection, it's now been a while since we've seen that point, was that Montserrat was closer to the attack line than the net, unless I'm misremembering it, but I could be.
Yeah.
This is either going to send Vegas home or end the match at least. They are home. Or continue things and send this to deuce. Challenging. So, yeah, it wasn't Montserrat. It was Karis Watson.
I don't either.
I don't think it was also.
I mean, she breathed on the net, but there's that's still legal,
that's
right?
That's allowed.
Okay. He's checking.
I don't think it would have been part of the play either. You know, even if there was something there.
It's a reach. It's a reach.
And now Atlanta is also at this point starting to get riled up and saying, like, okay.
Come on, guys. Yeah.
Let's get our story straight here. Let's do this challenge like we usually do. And if you don't see anything, let's go home. But so I understand where they're coming from. Well, yeah, Edmund taking issue. We didn't see it there, but they must be looking at something else if we haven't heard a definitive ruling. And this all goes back to Frisco and the Bolt 6 headquarters. Mm. And so we have limits here to what we know. We're not able to always hear exactly the thought process, but we know how great and efficient the system has been. However, when you have a match point like this, you got to make sure you clear everything up you need to. What are some of your takeaways, I guess, while we're waiting
out? While we're here. Yeah, I think Montserrat has done a great job distributing the ball, really getting her middles involved, which I know was kind of that halftime game plan from Coach Jajane. And Leah Edmund has been unstoppable. Seen some good things on the thrill side of the net as far as passing. But just getting that consistency outside attack has been a struggle for them.
Yeah, I mean, to me, against a different opponent, maybe Vegas gets something going today, but Atlanta just had too much. We're seeing why Atlanta is in first place and is likely to be 13-4. Okay, now
what do we got?
We're looking at this, and I still don't see anything there. I still don't see a net touch. And after a lengthy review, this is officially in the books, and an 8-0 run in Vegas's favor in the third set wasn't enough to turn this result. 3-0, Atlanta is the final. We will come back and talk with Shelly Fannin later on. The middle for Atlanta. Atlanta takes it in three. The Thrillville experience has been brought to you in part by Limitless Sports Medicine, National Youth Sports Nevada, the Skin Co. Lab, Nevada Army National Guard, Thomas Pennington Lim Tong Orthopedics and Sports Medicine, Finley Toyota, and by Clark County Credit Union. And our player of the match tonight in this sweet victory for Atlanta, Shelly Fanning, 11 kills, 450, also had four block touches for this great Atlanta 5 block. And Shelly is joining us right now with Kirsten Olsen, AJ Cannell. Shelly, you really got things going kind of midway through toward the end of the second set personally, and then carry that through to the third set. What was clicking for you tonight?
We start off really strong with our pins, establishing those quick, that quick offense. We did a really good job in defense, digging high, passing really well. So it was all around like a really solid team win.
And your relationship with your setter, I know that's a big thing for a middle blocker and a middle hitter. How has that gone for you and Monterey so far?
Marley is amazing. She's everything our team needs. She's energy. She gives us encouragement. She's just so athletic and runs the court really, really well. So she's amazing. We've done a great job establishing that relationship on and off the court.
Your coach talks all the time about just your chemistry as a team. I know Marley's a big part of that, but can you just kind of describe, like, when you have a team that's playing this well, sort of the chemistry that plays into that?
Yeah, we honestly, our team is amazing. Like, we have amazing people on and off the court, truly. We all get along really well. Like, I don't know, it's really special. It's a special team. It's a special group of people. And just, we go in, we battle, we fight hard, and we love each other day in and day out.
You could tell tonight, you guys had it going tonight, and just congratulations on the win, your performance.
Thank you so much. We appreciate it. Thank you.
Shelly Fanning, thanks so much for joining us. And we want to thank everyone for watching here. We've had a great crew once again working back in studio, and you see some of the final numbers there with Atlanta out hitting Vegas by over 100 points. The passing numbers, 60% positive pass rate for the Atlanta Vibe. And just all across the board, the blocking, I thought that the numbers don't even really tell the story, Kirsten, on how good the block was for Atlanta today.
No, they don't, but they were in every play involved. If it wasn't a touch, it was a block. Really good hitting by them, and also passing. They had the full, and they got all of their hitters involved, which is a true attribute to Monterey, really being able to distribute the ball around and get all their hitters involved.
Well, we enjoyed it, Kirsten. I know it wasn't, we were hoping for the great five setter or something, or a Vegas win tonight. Didn't happen, but we appreciate you filling in.
Absolutely.
Did a great job here.
My pleasure.
Tonight. And again, great job by our entire crew, producer Joe Kruger, Ted Spears back there as well, and so many others. AJ Cannell signing off from Lee's Family Forum here in Henderson. Atlanta puts Vegas away. Like I said, playing the right notes. 3-0 win.